Hey guys, Matt here for Science or Fiction, and today I'm gonna tell you how I plan to live forever with antioxidants. I just bought a ton of groceries. I've got some blueberries here. We have some dark chocolate. This is gonna be awesome, right? Now. Can antioxidants really lead to a longer, healthier life? Maybe you've heard that certain berries or nuts are good for you because of the antioxidants, and all that dark chocolate that you like to get around the holidays. You know, like Christmas, Valentine's Day, Passover, Easter, Arbor Day. Everyone eats chocolate on Arbor Day, right? Well, those antioxidants are gonna help you live longer too. Or is it the opposite? I mean, these headlines make it seem like you should lock that chocolate up and throw your acai bowl in the trash. So, which is it? Will antioxidants help you live longer or stop you from living altogether? Well, like a 2006 Facebook relationship status, it's complicated. First, you should know there's a thing called free radicals, which is not only an excellent band name, but they're also the natural byproducts of chemical processes like those that occur when our bodies turn food into energy. Free radicals steal electrons from our lipids, nucleic acids, and proteins, which slowly damages our genetic material and contributes to the aging process. And that's where antioxidants come in. Antioxidants intervene by providing extra electrons to free radicals so they stop stealing them from other places in our bodies. So it would seem that eating a bunch of antioxidant-rich foods like blueberries should then slow the aging process, right? Well, living longer isn't as simple as just ridding your body of free radicals. One study indicated that free radicals may be a product rather than a cause of aging. And in some circumstances, free radicals may actually increase the longevity of cells. Now, research has shown that people who eat more fruits and vegetables, which happen to be high in antioxidants, have a lower risk of disease. But there's no proof that it's the antioxidants in the food that's causing this. There's also little evidence that taking supplements full of antioxidants, like vitamin C or beta-carotene, offer any significant effect on heart disease, cancer, or other chronic conditions. Although, the jury's still out on vitamin E. You're okay for now, vitamin E, but I've got my eye on you. So, antioxidants may not have all the health benefits that media and nutrition companies claim. But could antioxidants actually be bad for you? Well, when it comes to antioxidant supplements, maybe. A study showed that one source of antioxidants, beta-carotene, may increase the chances of developing lung cancer in men who are heavy smokers. Rates of skin cancer were shown to be higher in women who took a combination of vitamin C, vitamin E, beta-carotene, selenium, and zinc. And studies have shown that rather than increasing lifespans generally, antioxidant supplements may be associated with shorter lifespans. In the end, antioxidant supplements are a mixed bag that you might want to be careful with. But antioxidant-heavy foods like dark chocolate and blueberries really don't have enough antioxidants to probably do much of anything. So keep on eating those, but only because they're delicious, not because they'll extend your life. Which reminds me, does anybody want any blueberries? How about some dark chocolate? I bought way too much. I thought I was gonna live forever. No? So antioxidants might not be that good for you, but vitamins are definitely good for you, right? Right? Find out in this video here. Don't forget to subscribe and keep coming back to Seeker for more videos.